Hello, ladies and gentlemen, MarauderEX here with more Let's Play Shining Force 3, Scenario 1, for Part 6. As you can see, you can wander the town, and I found the large piece of mithril. I'll go ahead and show where that is. I couldn't find the other healing potion. It says it's in one of the trees or plants inside one of the houses. I haven't seen it, so I don't know. But the mithril itself, if you can get out of the old man's way, is in this house. And I just want to show this off to be complete. If you search this box here, it's that one there. Nothing was found. That's one of the... You don't automatically search background, like barrels or trees or boxes or walls or any of that, but if you step up to something and you hit the search button and you search automatically, that means you've hit the right spot because you're going to find something. But if it brings up just the menu and asks if you want to inspect it manually, then no, there's nothing usually there. I can't say ever there because it all depends on how they scripted it. I want to say there's one item in the game that you have to manually look for, but I don't know. Alright, so now we complete our business in saraband. I also did get more healing items for everyone, so everyone has at least 2 healing items now. I only really had to buy 3 items. So, not that bad. I had more than I thought I did. But it was still one of those... I use way too many of these. Alright, so now we've successfully escaped saraband. And there is no Imperial presence, because Edmund and Tybalt are doing their jobs fantastically well. And by that, they are keeping everyone distracted while we leave. And saraband is very quiet as well. We should leave now. Yes! There's 5 of us. The 6 of us, if you count Benetrum. We definitely need to get the hell out of here. Said time to get the hell out of Dodge. The city of... or the town of Railhead. No, I was saying the city. I wanted to finish that sentence with the city of Townsville. And Benetrum is kind of like Batman without the badass martial arts and ass-kicking abilities, but he always has a plan. He's always got some idea of what to do. So he figured something might happen, so he stationed General Proton at Railhead. And General Proton is a Republic loyalist, so he is on our side. And he can help us get to the Republic because he has a larger force. But our entire plan was overheard from the other side of a mountain by the imposter. And they've knocked his ass out, honestly. Yeah, that would have been a good idea. Just leave him conscious and he just starts screaming, "They've got me, they've got me!" And then everyone just kind of turns to you. And then your little group of 3 people, it doesn't matter if you've got Spark level 2, you would have had to have fought 2 armies. Haha, you think you're clever. And we get into Battle 3. Battle on the way to Balsamo. And they will make their way to Balsamo. They do still count as units. If we had massive amounts of movement, we could catch up to them. But we don't. But dude's also got 120 HP, so even if we got to him, we wouldn't be able to do a damn thing against him. But they're going to slowly move towards Balsamo. If it was possible to catch up, you could catch up to them, but it's not, so... We are going to move forward and deal with all of these bad guys out in the open. But we're going to be careful about how far forward we move. Because this battle has a surprise. If you hit a certain point, you hit a trigger point that we don't want to deal with. Look at them, they move diagonally just across the plains. That's hacking to the nth degree there. Cheating bastards.
Here I come.
Alright, Mascarin, give him a hot foot that he won't soon forget. Who's got what for XP? I want to see where everyone's at. Mascarin is closest to level. Fantastic. Dontarius will finish him off. Or not. Not what I was expecting. In the least bit. Alright, Symbios, you finish him off. That was not what I was expecting. It's very rare for someone to block an attack like that, especially if you're using someone who's got a weapon that you're weak against. Huh. That's... color me dumbfounded. Alright, so we're gonna let them come to us. Or not. They're gonna run away. Yellow bastards. They're gonna keep moving. Alright, that is probably as far forward as I'm gonna move. And I'm gonna let them come to me. Which they're gonna do in style. Oh, one damage? One damage, you say? It's because you're on a land effect of 0 and I'm on a land effect of 15? And I've got much higher defense than I did the first time we fought you? Oh. Alright, I'll talk about land effect. Land effect's the same as it was in Shining Force 2. You've got land effect of 0, land effect of 15%, land effect of 30%. That increases a defense percentage. So you'll take less damage. If Grace is in a land effect of 30%, she'll take less damage than land effect 15 versus land effect 0. And it all depends on if your enemy's there as well. So if they're in it, they'll take the damage bonus or damage resistance as well. So you want to be careful. But this game also plays into terrain, like kind of like it did in Shining Force 2. You've got forest, grassland, dirt, mountains, and then other forms of unique terrain. Centaurs move best on grassland. They don't move well over mountains or hill terrain. He can't get up onto those mountains, where any of our other human character or humanoid characters can. They can move up to a certain level. And then flying characters, as you can see, are not affected by it at all. But flying characters are also unaffected by land bonus or land effect at all. So that's still, you know, a major point of this game. And Grace goes for the smack. She is still ridiculously useful at this point in the game. And the imposter has made it to Balsamo, which we knew he was going to. It was just not possible to catch up to him. I mean, you'd have to grind on this battle for weeks. Alright, I'm gonna move forward one more space. And this is probably going to trigger the event that I don't want triggered, but... It's gonna have to be triggered regardless, so we will deal with it as we can. Oh no, that's fine. So that's still a safe spot. I'd like to kill that other masked monk before triggering any of the events. The bats are inconsequential at the moment. They are pathetic. Come over here, Billy. It's a party. Everyone's invited. You know, for shits and giggles... No, we're gonna save the healing. It's going to need to be saved. Ah, damn it. It triggered. Okay. This is the event that is triggered that I was hoping I didn't trigger yet. As executors of the laws of Saraband, we must depart at once to search for our allied nation's dignitary, Emperor Dalmeric, and bring the criminal Benetrim to justice. According to the bridge guardsman Garrosh, King Benetrim and the Republic are innocent. However, Governor Garvin rejects that. We must carry on, do our duty, and bring these cadavers. So, Governor Garvin did not listen to Garrosh. So now we've got a new group of bad guys that we have to deal with. We're going to show them off. Saraband Knights are centaurs with lances, which means we need to keep them away from symbiotes. There's two there, and two there. Their boss is the defense commander. He is an infantry unit, but unlike most other infantry units, he's carrying a halberd. So he's actually kind of a threat, because he's an infantry unit, which means he won't get slowed down on the terrain. What they're suggesting is we stick toward the mountains to kind of bottleneck or to force them to go around and deal with them at our leisure, which is a fantastic strategy that we are probably not going to be sticking to. I should have saved this blaze for one of the Saraband Knights, but we need to kill guys. And where we're at now is kind of a threat to all involved. So, we've got to be careful. But, one thing you could do if you really wanted this fight to end quickly is just go after the Saraband commander. Or the defense commander. And you wouldn't have to worry too much about it. We still have one more masked monk to deal with. He's not a terrible threat at this point, because you saw how bad the other one went down. And I knew they were too close. This is why I saved the healing. Because I knew they were going to come. And he didn't go after a symbiote. That's unexpected. But that attack right there just goes to show you what land effect defense adds and what the weapon weakness adds. Dontarius took 1 point of damage. One. This guy's probably going to take only like 5 points of damage too. Oh, okay, seven. So I have a slightly higher attack than I was expecting with Dontarius. Alright. Kill the Saraband Knight. And Masker now views us as a partner. So now our friendship has gone up. And we can attack him. I don't think we can kill him. It'd be nice if we could. Well, not quite. Alright. Grace, heal our fearless leader. He needs it. And they're just gonna dick around over there. I'm probably not even gonna get to them. I'm gonna deal with the knights, honestly. And why he's getting behind Dontarius makes no sense to me. It doesn't increase his defense capabilities. She can kill him with one hit. Or not. Son of a bitch. Now I've got to waste a turn to kill someone who should already be dead. Leaving him with 1 HP would just not have been a smart decision, because he could still inflict a fair amount of damage on my group. But I am going to get in the higher defense areas, and we're going to start pegging these guys from a distance with arrows. Just hide in the trees and shoot arrows at them. We're going to resort to guerrilla tactics now. Hide Grace there. And they're gonna just move one step at a time. Alright. Land effect kick in. Four damage. See, that's actually... he took considerable amount less damage with that, so... as did Hayward. They only did 3 points of damage to Hayward. That's actually not bad. Alright, let's Mascarin's last blaze. But she made it a useful one. Alright, who's close to level? Everyone! Except for Grace and Hayward. That'll kill him, more than likely. Yep. Oh well, Dontarius is level 3. First to level 3. I'll have Hayward kill the bats. Oh, you rat little bastard. And Symbios... Symbios' magic attack is increased because he's next to Mascarin, but since he doesn't have offensive magic at the moment, it's kind of sad. He'll get some later, though. He will. Hayward. Kill the bat. One-shot the bat would be even better. Oh, thank you! That was just fantastic. So now we've only got 3 more guys to deal with. Cure myself. Physician, heal thyself! And get 3 experience points from it. Mazel tov. In fact, I'm probably going to send Hayward over to deal with, Hayward and Mascarin can go over there. Where is your attack range? So it shows that there are 2 bosses here, but if we kill them, they won't do anything. Well, if we kill the saraband leader, that'll do something. And it's probably not the best idea doing this in this fashion, but damn it, I thought I could hit the bat. I'll move you over there. I don't think that Masked Monk is really going to do it. I'm going to heal Symbios while I have the chance. If you poison attack him... no, you didn't poison attack him. You can kind of always tell when they're going to do a special attack because of how the camera angle changes. Alright, both bats are dead. And Hayward's level 3. Excellent. Now I just gotta heal you guys. And move you back to where you're not going to get the shit kicked out of you. And I need the XP for Grace, honestly. Alright, I'm gonna bring my force back over here. Maskern's kind of useless at the moment, so... But I am gonna bring Hayward. And I'm gonna heal Hayward. Because at this point, any of those guys could probably hurt him if he's out in the open. And I'm kind of made of money at the moment. I've got more than enough money to deal with what I need to deal with. And the defense commander comes in first. And even though he's got a halberd, which is a much higher attack weapon than what we've currently got, he does next to no damage. And don't do any significant damage. Thank you. Because I want to kill you guys to get the XP. Who's level what? It's level 3, level 3, level 2, and level 2. So you... Yeah, that's just not going to do well for any of us, honestly. We're going to move you over here. Which is not smart. As I look at that in retrospect, that was not my smartest move. But we can use this opportunity to heal you too. No, we'll cast heal. I won't waste it. Alright, yeah, we'll kill him. Why the hell not? Now I'm not terribly fussed about how bad this fight's gonna go. Because you're gonna go in and attack Symbios, which is fine. And do 5 damage, and then your friend's gonna go over there and do 4 damage, if I give him the chance to heal. But I'm gonna heal Symbios first to get Grace more XP, so it's all gonna work out. You guys have just kind of walked into a spiked wall. I really can't wait till I get more MP with Maskern, though. She needs it. Because she's very useful, but she just needs more MP to be more useful. And I've gotten to the point to where I need to level her up. And so I'm just gonna do stuff like that. And we'll attack the defense commander. Why not? It's not gonna change anything at this point. In fact, we'll keep attacking the defense commander. We will get Maskern and Grace up to level 3. We will accomplish this goal. Because we will have Grace heal. Grace's last heal. And then if I have to, I'll have her bean someone in the back of the head with that stick of hers. But that was fantastic, because now they have gone up a friendship rank. Which is great, because... That means, now that they're next to each other, Symbios' luck is higher. So there's a good chance of Symbios getting a critical his next attack. And attack the defense commander again. Attack you, you'll do 2 points of damage. And now she has one more XP before leveling. Alright, so didn't get the defense bonus. We're gonna go ahead and kill him, just because I'm tired of him being there. And tired of him doing damage. The 15 XP could have gone to Mascarin. Could have gone to Grace, but I'm tired of dealing with him. This fight's going on a little bit longer than I really want it to, but it's like, I can heal. In fact, just because Symbios keeps getting smacked around, I will heal. Why not? Because it's 10 XP. She's got to be close to leveling now. Yeah, you're 1 XP away. You're... okay. I'll have... and Symbio, everyone's going up in friendship. It's fantastic. And I'll have you attack to get a point. And Mascarin's level 3. Fantastic. And we'll have Symbios finish you off. What will I drop for this healing drop? I will drop the medical. Alright, now we gotta kill one more guy. That mask monk. So now we're gonna make a beel. I should have just killed him when I had the chance, but three knights, it's a little much. Right now, Hayward is the only person who doesn't view Symbios as a partner. That's because he's the newest person to our force. Symbios will more than likely be your major friend maker. And for shits and giggles, because this will level Grace up to level 3. Or not. Shit. Okay. Now you guys get to see Tornado level 1! Didn't do as much damage as I was expecting it to, but I think I'm fine with that. Alright. We will just surround him. I will let Grace either get the final kill or heal Hayward to get level 3. Because she needs it. Won't kill him, but hey. Yeah, we'll let Grace heal to get her needed XP. So everyone should be level 3, and MP increases by 2. So now she should have... no, because it doesn't increase perfectly. So her max... see, that's the one thing I don't like about this game. It's like, if you level up, you should get that MP. But you don't. Alright, Mascarin... smack him. You're not going to do any damage to him, but... now, who gets the kill? Who gets the kill? Dontarius. The only problem with the friendship bonus is if you're... damn it, Dontarius! If you're flanking everyone, like we are now, you can't get the friendship bonus because everyone's too far away from each other. Alright. nothing. I'm keeping what I've got. Give up on the antidote. All right, so we've defeated everyone. We have killed all the things. And General Varlant. You remember him. All right. Yeah, I'll keep the... This will be just a longer video. General Varlant, we've gone north with Lord Tybalt. They're still moving north and fighting. Tybalt ordered me to come here to assist King Benetrim, but it wasn't needed, because Symbios is a beast. And yes, they're going to come ashore. They're going to come ashore right now. Which is kind of why I didn't want to do this. Because this is going to take forever. So it's lots of talking. But we have two Imperial boats. The Empire has ships. We don't. Which kind of sucks. And that is Spiriel. She is one of the high-ranking Imperial generals. She's also a bitch. Tremble in fear before me. If the rumors are true. So many innuendos to be made from that, but Spiriel's army is all white knights. This guy is another Imperial general, Kruart. I hate Kruart. He is the definition of sleaze. However, he is topped by Erewhont. He is an Imperial prince. So that makes him Median's older brother, as is Majoron. Erewhont is the oldest prince, so he is next in line for the throne. Even though you would think Majoron just looks older, doesn't he? But Erewhont is... No, Majoron is the older. I thought Majoron was the older. I've got to look up to see who's older now. So, basically, the entire Imperial aristocracy is now here, and they're going to come. All but one. I think there's one other brother. And they are all out for blood. They've got armies they're sending in completely different directions. All, like, they're just fanning out in all directions, coming after us. See, even though he's a sleaze, he's got a good idea. It's like, oh, you go north to deal with Varlant. We'll go west and chase after us, but they don't know that that's where we're going. And Kruart's men look like the traditional Imperial soldiers we saw earlier that Median kept us from killing. And they're taking the boat back. So, don't let your guard down. And I love how they salute him. They don't salute the other prince, but they do salute him. But Spiriel's troops are so much better than Kruart's. I love how he's whispering to us, and we... Like, how far away are we? Alright. So, while they're doing that, we have to search Balsamo to see if we can find Emperor Domerik, so that we can put an end to all of this madness. But unfortunately, now that we're in Balsamo, we're even deeper in the lion's den. Because this entire village is just crawling with masked monks. I don't think they're praying for the conference's success. I think they were using this as a base to cause all the problems that they did. Alright, so now we get control. I'm going to go ahead and end this episode here and save it, and then in the next part we will explore Balsamo and deal with more of the story. So till then, later everyone!